Hello, Mayor John Tory here. Today on August 1st, I join black communities and Canadians at large in marking Emancipation Day. Because on this day, in 1834, slavery was legally abolished. And with that act, more than 800,000 people of African descent were freed across the British Empire. Since this historic watershed moment in our country's history and the history of the British Empire, we have recognized Emancipation Day and have officially proclaimed it here in the city of Toronto. Today is a day on which the freedom and free expression of identity of the black communities in Canada is proudly celebrated. But it must be accompanied by a recognition of the very fact that there was a need for emancipation and the terrible intergenerational trauma this has caused for our black communities. It also serves as a crucial and requisite reminder of the work that remains. It's a day on which we can firm up our resolve to act. Act to take down long-standing barriers and find antidotes to the continuing struggles faced by people of African descent so as to foster a more inclusive city. As Canadians, we can sometimes fall victim to the false belief that slavery isn't a troubling chapter in our own history, that it entirely happened somewhere else. But today especially, we must all be students and citizens of history and reflect and grapple with the grim periods of our very own past and its legacies. And we don't need to look too far back into the history books to find these injustices. Their legacies have endured and shaped the present reality for many Torontonians to this day. And that is why it is important that we change the name of Dundas Street, to acknowledge the more honest view we take of history today and to make a statement about who we are and who we want to be in the 21st century Toronto. And while the city has spearheaded remedies and means to overcome these inequities, such as the Black Scientist Task Force for Vaccine Equity as we fought the pandemic, we recognize there is much outstanding work to be done in many different areas. Please know that myself as mayor, as well as the city council and the city at large, are staunch allies in the fight against anti-black racism. Through our Confronting Anti-Black Racism unit at the city, the first of its kind in North America, that work will continue, with divisions inside the city, including the police service and the police board, looking to find new ways to support Toronto's black residents to build up their trust and to better serve them. City Council also recently launched Confronting Anti-Black Racism Advisory Committee as a council advisory body to ensure that the city's council members are being even more responsive to the pressing needs and interests of Toronto's black communities. We're doing a full appraisal, examining every aspect of the status quo without exception. This is a time to challenge norms and to commit not just to doing better, but doing our best to do what's right, to learn from our history. And we must recognize that gains have been made, but this is an ongoing journey towards realizing a greater sense of justice. With that, I wish Torontonians a day filled with both the celebration of the vibrant culture and valued contributions by black Torontonians, as well as a day to reflect on our past and our commitment to advancing equity and justice in our present. Thank you.